What do you know about Malik Obama?
Did you know Malik Obama is a Trump supporter?
I think he wrote a book or something about his big bad brother from Kenya. He even posed the question, is Michelle Obama really a man? I don't know what the fuck he's talking about there. You should probably Google that.
Hola, Bracho. Me llamo Miguel. Welcome to the kitchen with your boy, Giudini. We got a special Taco Tuesday / Cinco de Mayo for you. I don't even know why we celebrate Cinco de Mayo, but we're celebrating. Today we got a special setup for you today. We're gonna make some tacos, Mikey Shaner style. We got 2 pounds of ground sirloin, 90-10. We've got my special proprietary blend of seasonings, a little sliced, a little shredded lettuce, a little diced tomato with some green chilies, sour cream, and cheddar cheese, because you know your boy loves cheddar. And for all you purists, we've got a little bit of cilantro. Like I said, my proprietary blend of seasonings. Can't beat that shit. And after we're done doing that, we're also gonna make some of my homemade guacamole, drink a little bit of Corona, drink some tequila, and get down. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start with this. We're gonna put a little olive oil in here. We're gonna put a little diced onion, diced garlic. Get that nice and going. Not too much oil, you know, you don't wanna saturate the shit. We're gonna brown this up. After that, we're gonna add the meat to it. Save some of that garlic for our, what's the fucking name for it? guacamole, that's the shit. Getting drunk. you're drinking my margarita, man. Obviously, we don't need to do this with our proprietary blends of seasoning. Plenty of flavor in there. Can never have too much flavor when you're cooking tacos, right? Like I said, this isn't traditional. This is Mikey Shaner gringo style, Giudini gringo style. Bring a little flavor to it. Everybody likes tacos. If you motherfuckers eat Taco Bell and like it, you'll fucking like this. That's a promise. It's because I'm using Taco Bell seasoning. You smell that? You smell that through the camera? While we're letting that go, we're gonna do the meat right next door. Some people say, why are you doing the meat in a pot? I just always have. I've done it that way. It's easy for me to handle. I don't have to worry about fucking splatter everywhere. So you don't like it, don't fucking do it. I don't recommend you cooking in this shit. One, you don't wanna get your shit dirty. Two, it's hot as fuck. You ever go to a Mexican restaurant and you see the cook wearing some shit like this? You best believe that motherfucker sweat all over your food. So we're just gonna get the meat nice and browned up on one side. Then we're going to flip it, brown it up a little more. We're gonna add our seasoning, add a little bit of water in there just to get it nice simmered. And let it cook for about 10 minutes. That's about all it takes. The borracho taco is what I call it. Nice and browned up. Ooh, come back, come back. So how many of you guys out there been keeping up with the news? You've been watching all this crazy shit going on, right? What do you know about Malik Obama? Did you know Malik Obama is a Trump supporter? I think he wrote a book or something about his big bad brother from Kenya. He even posed the question, is Michelle Obama really a man? I don't know what the fuck he's talking about there. You should probably Google that. And he's a follower of QAnon. Now, I haven't really delved too much into this QAnon thing. I don't really know what it is. But allegedly, it's some kind of, you know, I don't know. You should just Google it yourself and look into it. QMap.pub. All right. See, we got a nice black char right there. That's how we like it nice and crispy. And we're not gonna add it there yet. Wait till I strain the fat, then we'll add it. Meat's not quite ready there. That's a lot of meat, dog. Oh man, it is so hot in this fucking thing. All right, this is looking good. I think the meat's about brown to where I want it. Doesn't seem to be a whole lot of extra fat in there. Since I used 90-10, see, there's not a whole lot of fat. We'll strain it just a smidge. Next, we're gonna go over here and take my proprietary blend, special stuff. Spread evenly. Then we're gonna take about 6 ounces of water, just a little. It's enough to make it moist, you know? We like it moist. Stir that bitch in there real good. That looks fucking delicious. So we're gonna bring it to a boil for about 30 seconds. Then we're gonna bring it to a simmer for about 10 minutes or so. Bring it to a real low heat. Simmer down, look at that. Gas is always nicer to use in this kind of situation because you can control the flame a lot better. So we got a nice little simmer going on. No boil. Margaritas and tequila. Probably shouldn't have drank before I did this. I probably shouldn't be dressed like a fucking idiot while I'm doing this, but Cinco de Mayo, baby. Bunch of stupid fucking gringos. Do you even know what the fuck you're celebrating? No, I don't either. Here I am, dressed like a fucking dick in the kitchen, sweating my dick off. Yo, so they're celebrating beating the French. 1862, a Mexican army defeated Napoleon's. That's fucking reason enough to fucking celebrate for me. Fuck the French. While we got the taco shit simmering, while we've got the taco meat simmering, we're gonna take this time to make Giudini's homemade guacamole. And I can't take credit for it. I got the recipe from a dear friend of mine, Amanda Liston. This is Amanda's guacamole recipe. Thank you. 3 avocados. I've got 4 avocados here though. That makes a lot of sense, Michael. All right, we're gonna use the rest of this shit. Ooh, we're gonna kick it up a notch. So we've got 3 avocados. We've got some chopped onion and chopped garlic. We're gonna take some lemon, fresh lemon juice, fresh lime juice.
Bring it right over here.
We're gonna get some of our diced tomatoes and a little bit of cilantro. Well, a lot of cilantro, because that shit's fire. And then just mix. Mash and mix, baby. Like a lot of you fake-ass DJs, just mash and mix. Holler at your boy. DJ Giudini coming through. Wow, 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 wow. Now, the thing about, obviously, guacamole, everyone's got their own little, you should put this in it, you should put this in it, you should put this in it. One thing I didn't add that I typically do is olive oil. Obviously, olive oil is going to make it a little runnier, but we're going to stay away from that right now. I think there's plenty of flavor in here.
Your boy's nice in the kitchen.
You would have thought I was a fucking Mexican. Pancho Villa. Oh, look at that guacamole. God damn. Come over here and check out what we got going. You gotta whip it counterclockwise. Remember, when you're whipping it, always, 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 always whip it counterclockwise.
I don't know why this is what they say in the rap songs. Cooking up dope in the crock pot.
All right, so next step in the process. These are handmade, straight from Publix. Fucking Great Gamma Guadalupe made them. So you could add butter, you could add olive oil, or you could just raw dog it like I do. Bang. Now what we're gonna do is let it get nice and toasty on one side. And any of you fat bastards who've ever been to Taco Bell know what a cheesy gordita crunch is. This is gonna be similar to that. My own little take on it. Remember what we said about cheddar, right? We really like cheddar. Fat motherfucker.
So how do you want yours? You want some guac? You want a little bit of lettuce? Put a little sour cream, a little cilantro. I'll put a little bit of everything just for you, okay? Got you.
So that's getting melted. You can see the cheese there melting up just nice. Make it a little, So you can make like a quesadilla this way. Basically, that's kind of what I'm making is like a little tiny quesadilla, but we're gonna eat it as a taco because we fat like that. Boom, come over this way. It's a little shreddy letty, a little
guac
right on it. But we're gonna put it on that side spread it. Spread that shit. Giudini approved. And top it all off, a little bit of sour cream. Mix it in there. Mix it up. All right, guys. We're getting there. Got it pretty much put together. Let's see how it's nice and brown. Kind of mash it down a little bit. So basically, if you're using a tortilla this side, you're making a quesadilla. Use a smaller tortilla. It's gonna be more like a little cheesy gordita. I'm a fat fucker, so that's big enough for me. What we could have done, we could have rolled it up and thrown it in the deep fryer and made a chimichanga out of it. That might be another episode. Don't tell nobody.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Look at that.
This Speedy Gonzalez, the fastest mouse in all of Mexico. Arriba, 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 andale, andale, andale. Boy, I'll tell you what, if some of you guys ever saw the outtakes on this shit, half of you would love me more and the other half would probably write your congressman about why I should be censored. But fuck you, because you're never gonna see it.
All right, let's see what we got going on here.
We're looking good and golden brown. Made a mess, look at me. I do it better than the Mexicans and Mitchie Cohen, motherfucker. Woo! God damn! Guadalajara, you ain't got shit on me! Y'all want some? Here, I don't have COVID-19, take a bite.
I fucking fire, yo.
Fuck, that's good. That's really good. Man, Nueva Cantina Shaner Edition. About to take over the Mexican game in St. Pete. Anyways, guys, happy Cinco de Mayo. To all my barachos and the gringos and my Mexicanos, Chicanos, my peoples. Enjoy. Drink your tequila responsibly. Drink your Corona. Don't pass it. And holler at me next time. I'll be here in the kitchen with your boy, Giudini.
Woo!
All right, guys. That's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to like it, comment, share, subscribe. Great Giudini. Tell your friends and family. You need a good laugh or you need a good recipe, something's quick and easy and simple, holler at your boy.